This video explains the patient journey for patients having transcatheter aortic valve implantation, or TAVI. TAVI is a way of replacing the aortic valve by passing a tube through an incision in the groin. This is how the majority of people have this procedure performed and is done under local anaesthetic while you are awake. For some people, accessing the heart valve from the leg is not possible, and an incision has to be made in the chest wall or breastbone, and this is usually done under general anaesthetic, where you will be asleep for the procedure. If this is the case, the procedure will differ slightly from this video, but the nurse will explain in clinic the differences so that you are prepared. Before you are admitted to hospital for your TAVI, you will be seen by the specialist nurse in clinic to prepare you for your admission. The procedure will be explained in detail so you know what to expect. Family members often like to be present at this appointment, and you will have the opportunity to ask the nurse any questions you might have. Most patients are admitted on the morning of the procedure to the cardiology day unit. Here you will be seen by the doctors who will be involved in your procedure. They will recap how the TAVI is performed and may want to examine you. The ward staff will prepare you for the procedure, which will mean changing into a hospital gown. Sometimes the nurse will need to remove some hair from your body using clippers to prepare the skin for the procedure. When you arrive in the catheter lab, a member of the team will go through a checklist of questions about your health. It should only take a few minutes, and then you will be taken into the room where the procedure is performed. The staff will spend some time making sure you are comfortable on the bed, and then the stickers will be placed on your body in order for us to be able to monitor your heart rhythm. A special cleaning solution will be wiped over the surface of your skin from the chest down to the groin area to make sure the skin is clean before covering you with a blue sterile sheet. A doctor will put a small tube into the wrist and at the leg so that we are able to keep you monitored and control your heart rate during the procedure. After we have injected some local anaesthetic to numb the leg, we then insert the bigger tube used to deliver the valve into the vessel in the leg called the femoral artery. This bit of the procedure can take a little while, as the doctor takes special care to make sure the tube is in exactly the right place. We also put some stitches in at the wall of the blood vessel to help us stop the bleeding at the end of the procedure. The heart valve is mounted on a delivery system which allows it to be made smaller to enable it to be passed through the big tube in the leg, up and across the body, and into position in your existing heart valve. The doctor will then either use a balloon to inflate the valve, or the valve will expand by itself into position. You might feel lightheaded at this point as we take control of your heart rate to make sure the valve doesn't move position when it's going in. Once the doctors are happy that the valve is in and functioning well, the tubes and lines will start to come out. A small band will be placed around the wrist and is inflated with air to stop any bleeding from the artery, and the stitches in the leg will be pulled tight to close the blood vessel. The doctor will also sometimes press firmly on the leg to stop any bleeding. You will then be taken back to the coronary care unit to recover. You will be connected to a heart monitor and will have to be on bed rest for a few hours. You can eat and drink as soon as you feel ready, and the nurses will keep a check on your leg before slowly starting to sit you up. Later that day, or sometimes the next day, you will be able to get out of bed and mobilise normally. We advise that if you use any walking aids, such as a stick or Zimmer frame, you bring them into hospital with you to help you mobilise after the procedure. You will be reviewed by the team and informed when you can go home. You will also be given some advice about your recovery. Most patients get home the day after their TAVI procedure, but some patients may need to stay in hospital longer.